Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of My Summer Car. In the last episode, we built the engine up, kinda. And I ended the episode trying to put the hoist on there, and I figured out why it wouldn't let me. It does attach here, but as you see on the back, there's no hook or a loop for it to attach to. And that's because I don't have the header on yet. So we have to put the header on so it goes like this, right under the carburetor. And it is an 8mm. So once we get the header on, where's the other bolts at? Should be inside here. Nope. Oh, it's on top. Should be three on top and two on bottom. So now it should let us put the engine on the hoist. Spin back around right. Move the hoist back in location. That should be good. Get the 10mm. And now, let's move the engine out just a little bit. Now if we tighten these, 10mm. Still didn't hook. Okay. I'm pretty sure it worked. So if we jack this up, yes, it worked. Awesome. Now we can start putting our parts on here. Like the engine plate. Oop. That's not how you put it on there. Come on. Put that on. We could run to the store and get our parts and come back. Kind of just want to finish this. So let's grab the starter. Where did I put the starter at? Starter, where are you? I had it. I tried to put it on and it didn't work. Oh, I put it right here. The starter will go right here. And we need 7mm. This makes it a little bit easier to work on too, because we can actually get up under it. Ooh, kind of need to put the oil pan on, don't we? Hopefully we can still put it on with the starter there. Now we need the clutch, which is right here. Cover plate. All this stuff goes together. So I think, let's see. The cover plate's right there. So I think the clutch goes to the cover plate, and then this goes to this, like that. And then this part goes on. Nope. Oh, we're missing a flywheel, huh? Gotta have the flywheel to actually go somewhere, right? Let's put the flywheel on. Tighten these bolts. I had a car one time. It was a Honda Civic when I was still in high school. And I bought an engine swap for it. And it came with the engine and transmission already together. So we put it in, and everything worked fine. But eventually, it started getting hard to go in gear. I'm like, what in the world's going on? You know, this is basically brand new car, or brand new engine and transmission. Why is it being like this? And eventually, it just wouldn't go into gear at all. And I pulled the motor and the transmission back out. It was like 2 months later, so like I was really frustrated. And you see how the clutch and goes to the flywheel and it's mounted to the crank of the engine, right? Well, when I pulled the transmission up off the engine block, the flywheel and stuff came with it. And the bolts that held the flywheel on was stripped out. Like, somehow they just, I guess they were loose and they just, I don't know. I don't exactly know what happened. But I wasn't happy. That's just one of the many times something's went wrong with one of my cars. Oh well. So we got those. And these were 6 millimeters, by the way. Now we need the oil pan. It goes on like this. Yep. Let's get the tools to put it together or tighten it. And these are 7 millimeter. Come on. We need to go get a drink real quick and worry about us. We've been building this engine nonstop for a while. We're getting kind of thirsty and hungry. Any bolts right here? No, I don't. I think this is the last one. Should be 8 of them. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 5, 6, 7, and 8. Oh, see? I missed this one. That would have turned out bad. Now we need the drain plug. Tighten it up. It's going to be 13. Okay. Let's go get a drink real quick. Oh, I haven't heard the beer bubble in a while. Is it still... We need to listen for it. We'll drink the juice so we'll have empty containers. Oh, it actually doesn't do anything for our thirst. Okay. We'll just drink some water. I thought the juice helped our thirst, but it doesn't. Might as well go ahead and eat some macaroni. There we go. And I do not hear it bubbling, so I think the alcohol is actually done. I'm not sure exactly how we put it in the bottle. Oh, yep. There we go. There's one of them. I think you can actually sell this to the alcoholic. We need more jugs. There's another one. Not sure how good it is. I'm gonna go ahead and drink this. So we'll just have some empty containers. There's another one. And we're going to drink one and see what it does. It might make us sick. So we have a lot. We need a lot more containers. Let's go ahead and put the lid back on, I guess. Close this up. Are you guys ready? What's it going to do? It didn't make us. I don't know if I did that right or not. Because it didn't make us weak, like sway like we're drunk or anything. So I'm not sure if I made it right. I wish you would get the shower working. But we're going to finish building the motor. We're almost done. We are almost done. Turn the water off. I'm just going to let it dribble. We're going to go ahead and put the transmission on. Right here. It goes on just like this. And we need 7mm. There's going to be 6 of them. That's 1, 2, 3. Make sure that's tight. 4, 5, 6. And that's all of the 6mm, or yeah, 7mm, my bad. And then there's 1 10mm, which is somewhere. I'm not sure. So all those are already tight. Where is the 10mm? Do I have the 10mm? Do we have the 10mm? Why is it saying that there's a 10? Maybe it's talking about the after I put this guy on. Now is there a 10mm? No. I do not want to leave a bolt loose. I'll have to come back to that. So we need a 6mm for this guy. That has me worried now. Where is the 10mm at, I wonder? I don't know, guys. Is it there? Are all of them tight? Oh. Whew. I wasn't even looking out there. Okay. So the 10 millimeter is right there. Okay. Now we need to put the rocker cover on. Or the valve cover. Just like that. And we need a 7 millimeter for it. Which we'll have to take it back off after to tune it or whatever to adjust the valves. If I can press the right button. Coming along pretty nicely, huh? So now we need a fuel pump. Just right. Where's the fuel pump at? Fuel pump. There you are. And I think it goes. It's on this side. And it's 7 millimeter also. So now the fuel pump is on. Put the air filter on. It's 6 millimeter and these two guys right here. That. And now the only thing we have left to do is put the oil filter on, which it goes on the front. And we'll just tighten this by hand, just like that. And the engine is complete for the moment. So we could do we go ahead and finish building all the parts on the car out there before we push it in? I say we still got a little bit of time left in the episode. Let's go ahead and mount it. So we need 11, I believe. Let's go ahead and grab this and we'll move it out here. We'll try to mount it. Oh my god, are you kidding me? What in the world? Just, I swear, this game. Hopefully nothing's damaged. Can I pick it up? Let's flip it this way. Hopefully nothing broke on the motor, the engine. Let's go ahead and lower this down. That wasn't even my fault. It just kind of started glitching out. I guess I want to end the episode here. At the start of the next episode, we'll mount the engine to the car. I'll go ahead and hook this back up and have it out. I won't put it in until I'm recording. We're going to make a run to the store, get our parts, and put another order in. I'm not sure if we can actually put an order in before we pick up our parts. There's one sewage job at the moment, which I'm not going to worry about right now, because I'm going to let two or three get on there because fuel is so expensive. And how much gas is in here? So we'll drive this oh, this is almost empty. So we'll drive this to the store, go ahead and get fuel, and pick our parts up. But thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next episode. Hopefully you're enjoying the series. I know I say that every video, but I mean it. I'm having a blast with the game. Even though it's kind of twitchy sometimes, like, that wasn't my fault right there that the engine fell off. But we have to deal with it, right? If you want to play the game, it is early access. So those are the kind of things you have to watch out for. But if you enjoyed the series, make sure to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment, because I will reply back. But I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye.